Sort of a bitch, is she, eh? I mean, what sort of a rotten mole dumps her own kid?
Oh, I'm not going to listen to
this. Oh, and what's this? The proud father.
Hazel, just leave it. I will explain it all to you later on.
Well, that'll be real interesting. You can explain to me why your daughter just threw her kid away like a load of rubbish.
McKenzie has offered to purchase the set with her own money.
Why would you do that?
I think it's a very generous offer.
We want to buy the thing ourselves.
Well, let's put it to the vote, shall we, Mrs. Powell?
All right, those in favour of McKenzie paying for the set, raise your hands.
Well, that settles it then. We'll get the necessary consent paper signed now.
The pleasure's all mine, Mrs. Davidson.
Honey, let's just talk this through, okay? I mean, if you sit down with me and you just get it off your chest, you're going to feel a hell of a lot better, I promise you. It'll be all right.
Don't patronize me. You haven't got the right. As far as Jeff's concerned, I don't want to see him ever again. Or his child.
If I believed for one second that you meant that, I'd walk out the door and I'd never come back. Honey, you have got to talk this over with Jeff.
I just can't.
He's a good husband, isn't he? He loves you. He loves the baby. I mean, he came all the way down from Queensland to find you. You at least owe him some sort of explanation.
For God's sake, Mum, leave me alone. I just need more time. Don't you understand?
I understand, but do you? Jeff needs you, Laurie. The baby needs you. And he's a beautiful little baby. Don't you think that David deserves some chance? Honey, I know what you're feeling. I know what you're going through. But you're not on your own. Jeff will help you. I'll help you any way we can.
Mum, it's no use. I can't trust myself. I don't even know what I'm going to do to my own baby.
Have a little faith in yourself, Laurie. God, when you see that baby again, when you see how helpless he is, you're going to feel differently.
I can't see him, and I won't. Don't you understand that?
All I understand is that I don't want you to make the same mistakes I've made. Laurie, I'm your mother. I love you. I want to help you, honey. Please, can't we just talk this through together?
And it's awful the way they all suck up to Nola. After all, it's you they've got to thank for being allowed to watch TV in the first place.
Yeah, well, they've all got pretty short memories around here. Maybe I should jog a few by bashing a couple of heads together.
Well, I don't reckon Nola's memory needs jogging because she's got that little sign on her chest to remind her.
Well, if she's stinging as much as I am, it's still not enough.
Oh, fair go, B. It's better than having to part out with our own cash. I reckon she's just trying to make up for all the trouble she's caused.
A sort of goodwill gesture, eh?
Well, yeah. I mean, she didn't have to do it now, did she?
Very cool. Congratulations.
What do you mean?
Popularity comes pretty cheap around here. The trick is making it stick. So I'd make the most of yours while it lasts.
Why don't you speak up, Smith? Afraid the other women will think it's sour grapes.
Don't push your luck, McKenzie. I could just give you another little souvenir.
I reckon it's a crying shame. I mean, you and Laurie should have made a go of it for the sake of the baby.
Yes, well, I'm trying to make a go of it.
Too many marriages bust up these days. No one takes their vows serious anymore. Seriously. Look. I know all about broken marriages, Jeff.
Yeah, sure.
Marriage is a precious thing. It's a holy thing. Don't break it up.
Look, I'm not trying to break anything. You're talking to the wrong person, Hazel.
Laurie. It's not worth a second thought for a good bloke like you. I mean, how could she dump a beautiful little kid like Johnny? Not worth a second thought. Forget about her.
I don't see how I can forget her and at the same time save our marriage.
Oh, Hazel, are you at it again? Go and make yourself some coffee.
How did it go?
No. She doesn't want to know about David.
But she can't just shut him out as though he'd never been born. It's unnatural.
That's what postnatal depression is all about. How can she behave naturally? She doesn't want the baby. She's frightened she might hurt him.
She wouldn't do that. I'll soon talk some sense into her.
Look, losing your temper isn't going to prove anything. Laurie's sick. She needs help.
She needs a kick up the backside.
Oh, I suppose you're the one that's going to give it to her, huh? Think about it, Jeff. Just give her some breathing space. Can't do any harm. It might be the only hope we've got.
How are the new sleeping arrangements? You and Colleen getting along cosily?
It's none of your business.
Maybe not. I must say I never expected you two to set up house together. You've had your little tiffs in the past, haven't you?
Nothing serious. We get on quite well, actually.
Oh, well. It's early days yet, isn't it? We'll just have to wait and see, won't we?
Well, you can wait as long as you like. It suits us both, just for now.
Should be close to $40 there.
Near enough. Business looks good. Should be close to $100 altogether with this lot.
Won't you have to fork out a bit to pay for the TV set?
Oh, don't be stupid. It's not coming out of this. What will the screws think? No, I'm getting that from WA. My little bit of payola should pay off 10 times over. I won't need a front woman anymore.
$40?
Well, you did pretty well by me. And you know how to keep your mouth shut.
You know, including me wages, that'll give me about $90 to start off with on the outside. Not bad, eh?
Well, just watch yourself the way you try and get it out of here. Those screws would be very happy to get their sticky little fingers on that roll.
Well, I'll get it out all right. Don't you worry.
Oh!
Oh, hell. Hey, B, there's plenty of coffee. Why don't you make yourself a cup?
No, thanks. Comes from McKenzie. I'm not touching anything she's had her hands on.
Why can't you sleep?
I don't know. Oh, yes, I do. It's that damn trial tomorrow. You know, if I did the right thing by Patty, I'd make sure that murdering bitch got shipped right back to Western Australia.
But you can't, can you?
No, I can't. Oh.
What's up, Bee Love? Can't you sleep?
Oh, sorry, Lizzie. I'm just a bit restless, that's all.
Oh, what you need's a nice cup of coffee. I'll get up and
make... No! If anyone else mentions coffee, I'll tip the whole Fleming jar down the sink.
Leave it, Lizzie. Go back to sleep.
Well, I can't go back to sleep now I'm awake. Take me half the night to get off again. What I need is a nice little nightcap. What you gotta do, Bee, is clear your mind of everything, and then you'll get off.
It's not that easy, Lizzie. I thought I'd learn to live with Patty's death. But tomorrow I have to stand in that witness box and help that wicked bitch get an easy time for killing the kid.
We all miss Patty, love. But there's nothing we can do to bring her back.
Yeah, but... Lizzie, she shouldn't have even been here, you know that. She hadn't got caught up in that stupid kid Addie's escape, she wouldn't have been caught. She would have been miles away. She'd have been free. Instead, she gets the chop from Nola. A sucked out slag.
Yeah. Poor Patty. Fancy getting copped the night before you get released.
Pity you don't remember that when you're dealing with that murdering bitch.
Well, we've got to trade with somebody, Bee, and everyone's in it.
Well, everyone should stop for a minute and just take stock. They're all so busy spending, they don't care who they're dealing with. But I do. I'm taking stock of everyone that deals with Nola. And when the time comes, they'll all get a lot more than they bargained for.
Adler, Grant, you're on cleaning duties. Jones, Birdsworth, Daniels, Quin, Shaw, Kennedy and Anderson to the laundry.
Why do I have to work today?
You'll work how and when you're told, Quin.
But I'm up for release.
Your release isn't due till this afternoon. Till then, you're still a prisoner and you'll work.
McKenzie and Smith, go to reception with Miss Ferguson. You're due in court.
Oh, good. I can't wait.
Get back in line, Quin.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, I just want to say goodbye.
Make it quick.
Bye, Nola. Bye, Bee. Thanks for everything.
So long. Make sure you pick your mates as well as you pick your horses. I don't want to see you back in here.
Sure.
Come on, hurry up.
Ready when you are.
Oh, he's gorgeous, isn't he?
He looks okay to me.
Yeah. I never thought I'd be so keen to get my arms around a fella.
Well, I'm very pleased you came along, Mr. Maynard. We had picked up the matter of the child's profound deafness, disorientation, lack of response to oral stimuli. Mentally, he's as sound as a bell.
That's a relief, Doctor.
Oh, look at him.
His mother, though, reckons that she doesn't want any part of him.
I think it's just because she feels she would hurt him or something, but that's not likely, is it?
It's possible.
Well, couldn't you give her something to calm her down?
Well, postnatal depression is treatable. These days, it's recognizable early enough to prevent possible harm to the child. But as to the mother, it all depends how willing she is to take treatment. Delay can lead, in some cases, to complete mental breakdown.
God, as serious as that?
I'm afraid so. Mr. Maynard, it's very important that you persuade your wife to accept medical attention. It's a long, uphill battle for her.
I was beginning to think that she was just stacking on a turn.
Far from it. Her illness is very real, and I'm afraid it's futile trying to force her to accept the child. She must take the decision for herself. Tragically, it can happen that the mother never comes to accept a particular child, even though she may have others.
Well, there'll be no problem with anyone accepting David, I can tell you.
I'm relieved, I must say, that you're willing to accept responsibility as the father, Mr. Maynard. As he suffers from profound deafness, it's unlikely that the state would ever put him up for adoption. With no one to go to bat for him, he'd be institutionalized.
Well, I've had to chuck everything up to come down here. I haven't got anywhere to live. I just need to know how to get out of this mess.
Well, I can refer you to the medical social worker. She'll give you advice.
Thanks. Meanwhile, I was wondering whether I might leave David here at the hospital just for a couple of days while I sort out what I'm going to do.
You say you want the child?
Yes, of course I do.
All right. I'll recommend we run a few more tests on him. That will delay things a bit. But I warn you, it's only temporary. If you don't claim him, there's nothing I can do to prevent his discharge into state care.
Thanks.
It won't happen. Look at
him. It'll be all right.
Grandson, huh?
All right, you can have these two with my compliments.
Lovely day for a trial, isn't it?
Don't push your luck, McKenzie. I might just tell them I didn't see or hear anything, and you could wind back in WA facing a hangman.
Perjury's against the law, Smith. Or haven't you heard?
Where do I put this?
Oh, just leave it here by the counter. I'll have it cleared later.
You going to sign for it?
Sure.
Well, what do you know? The new TV.
Give yourself a pat on the back, McKenzie. Your generosity to your fellow prisoners is only exceeded by the size of your ego.
Anything you say, Miss Ferguson.
Black and white.
The new telly's arrived. I just saw them putting it in the rec room.
Gee, that'll brighten up the house a bit.
Oh, I don't know. I don't reckon we should watch it. You know what Bea said about touching anything that Nola had anything to do with?
Well, she wouldn't have meant us to sit staring at a blank screen now, would she?
Well, I still reckon we have to check up with Bea.
You're mad. You finally got the television set you were sweating over. Now you don't want to watch it. What's the matter with you?
Nola got it for us. That's what's the matter.
That's no reason why you should all have to suffer just because Bea's got it in for Nola. Stand up to her, why don't you?
Oh, come off it. Bea's still tough dog.
Yeah, well, Bea's right about what Nola done to Penny. But I don't reckon we should go on about it forever. Never look a gift horse in the mouth, I reckon. So where's the paper? I want to see what's on.
Bea's not gonna like it.
A lot of the women didn't even know Patty. I don't reckon it's fair to deprive people when they weren't even involved. Struth, I was really looking forward to watching. Now you two have got me so mixed up, I don't know what to do for the best.
Well, it'd solve everything if the department had let me help look after David. Whew, I'd have Buckley's. Not only is my record the pits, can you just see little David being raised here by all those foster mothers? You'd end up the father of a juvenile delinquent.
Bad enough having a delinquent mother-in-law. No, seems like Mum's the only answer. No, I don't think she'll mind much. As long as it doesn't take too long to sort Laurie out.
Well, you mustn't get your hopes up. You know what the doctor said.
Oh, that's the trouble, Judy. I just can't accept all this stuff about, what was it?
Postnatal depression.
Yeah, I don't understand it.
Well, having a baby is more than a physical shock. There's hormonal changes, mental adjustments.
And if the baby's not healthy, it's even harder.
But he is healthy. He's only deaf.
He's handicapped, love. He's going to need special care. And you're going to have to get used to the idea that Laurie may decide not to come back.
Don't say that. I'm not equipped to bring him up alone.
Well, I'll help you all I can.
It's Laurie's responsibility just as much as mine. She's got no right to foist him off onto someone else just because it suits her.
Yeah, but she's...
Yes, I know. Postnatal depression. Well, I'm depressed, Judy, understand? I'm depressed because my wife's lost her reason. And I'm depressed because unless Laurie's prepared to pull herself together and be a proper wife and a mother to David, I'm not sure I even want to see her again.
Hello, Meg.
I'm afraid Colleen is not here this morning. She's appearing as a witness in court.
I see. Actually, it was you that I wanted to talk to.
Me? Well, I don't think I can be of any help, Patrick.
Well, Colleen's staying with you. You two seem to be pretty close these days.
Like two peas in a pod.
Is there somewhere we can have a private word? I want some advice.
Well, it's...
Just for a couple of minutes.
It's all right. I can manage on my own.
All right, then, but you just have to sign in first.
You seem to be in demand from all the pals these days.
I didn't know who else to turn to, Meg. Look, I'm at my wit's end. Robert's at that awkward age. He's all cut up. I just don't know how to handle him.
What about Jennifer?
She's all right. Thank God she's there. She's the only one that can reason with him. Damned if I can. Look, I know this is maybe asking a bit much, Meg, but could you talk to Colleen and persuade her to come back? Give it another try?
I can't take sides, Patrick. I sympathize with you, but it's best I stay out of it.
I thought you were supposed to be your best friend.
Well, we're only workmates. Colleen's just staying with me for now, and after that we still have to go on working together. You must sort it out between you. I'm sorry, there's nothing more I can do.
Well, at least it's good to know that they won't press charges.
No, not if there's no signs of cruelty or neglect.
I wish there was some way we could make Laurie see what she's doing.
Well, the state won't be able to put him up for adoption without your consent.
Well, the doctor says no one would be likely to take him on the way he is. And anyway, I'll never give him up.
Good. The institutions are full of kids nobody wants. Breaks your heart to see them.
Well, thank you very much.
Nobody's going to take David away. Nobody.
Nobody wants to, Jeff. Laurie'll see sense. I know my own daughter.
Who'd want to? At least he cares about his kid, which is more than anyone can say for Laurie.
Why don't you shut up, Hazel? I've had it up to here with you. Laurie is my daughter, and there's nothing that she could ever say or ever do that would ever make me shocked. I've been there myself, remember? Now, you mind your own business, because I've had it up to here with problems.
Well, so what? Everyone's got problems.
Then don't you criticize until you've come at least a part of the way to solving your own.
Well, I think it's about time that I solve mine. This has gone far enough.
Where are you going?
To see Laurie. And if I can't talk sense into her, I might just try knocking it in. Laurie, being deaf isn't the end of David's world. He can still lead a normal life. He's got us to help him.
Here, and he's not going to be able to speak. He'll just make noises like an animal.
I can't talk to you. You're acting like a child. This isn't a toy we're talking about, Laurie. It's a baby, our baby.
I don't want him.
You can't just chuck him away when you're sick of playing with him. You can't put him away in a cupboard and forget about him.
Jeff, it's your fault he's like this in the first place. If you'd taken better care of me when I was pregnant, it wouldn't have happened.
How was I supposed to know those kids had German measles? What am I, psychic or something?
Look, it's not that I don't love him, I do. I love him too much. Too much to see him just struggle through life like that. The people staring at him and laughing at him behind his back. Perhaps somebody stronger could fix...
Sweetheart, there isn't going to be anyone stronger. He may never be adopted.
Jeff, stop it.
He's handicapped.
I'm not going to listen to you.
And if you reject him now, he'll probably spend the rest of his life in a state orphanage.
I don't want to hear this,
Laurie,
Jeff.
If you don't open your eyes and ears, David's not the only one who's going to be lost. You'll be lost too.
Now, they're showing all those old films with Barbara Stanwyck this week. Double Identity is on tonight.
Yeah, but Mesh, the movie's on. Don't tell me we have to sit around and watch old films tonight.
Oh, I've seen enough war in my time. I don't like those.
Mesh is supposed to be funny.
Too much blood. It turns me guts.
All right, if you lot haven't got enough work to do, I can arrange for the load to be increased. All right, Quin, come with me and to report to reception for your release.
Oh, thank God for that.
Oh, see you, Faye.
See you, Max. Oh, look after yourself.
Bye, Lizzie. Come on, take come care. Over.
Move it.
Bye. How'd you go?
Lousy. She won't even listen. I don't know how, but I'm going to make a home for my son.
You'll manage, and I'll help you any way I can.
Thanks. Oh, I phoned Mum on the way back here. She's agreed to take David for a while.
Oh, that's great.
I don't know how she'll manage. Dad's sick, and she's still got Derek and young Lisa living at home. It's tough on her, but I just can't see any other way.
She'll never be able to do it. Well, I may have failed Laurie when she was a baby, but there's no way I'm going to fail my grandson. If Laurie doesn't come back to you, well, then I'll help you raise him.
But you can't. The authorities will never let you.
Well, not at Driscoll House, they wouldn't. But if I gave up the halfway house, they wouldn't be able to do a damn thing. I can go where I'm really needed.
Take this through to Mrs. Davidson's office, will you please, Cora?
Quinn's ready to be processed out, Mrs. Morris.
Right, I'll see to a personal fix. And you're owed $53 in wages, Quin.
Hey, I was nearly spot on.
Right, Quin, search time. Oh, come on, Quin, you know the rules by now. Into the showers. Very nice indeed.
That's mine.
Oh, no, it isn't. The only money coming to you is what you've earned.
Well, I earned that too.
Did you now? Perhaps you'd like to tell me how you earned it.
What's the difference? I'm getting out of here anyway. I've been working as cover for Nola McKenzie.
McKenzie, eh? I might have known. What's she up to?
Well, you know them buy-up goods that went missing? That was Nola. I don't know where she stashed them, but she's been flogging them off at a profit. That $40 is my cut.
And this is my cut. Right. Now, you'd better hide that, Quin. Wouldn't want to lose it, would you? Quinn's ready to sign for her wages, Mrs. Morris.
Sign there. You're free to go. Okay.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris.
Faye? Oh, Faye, love.
Hi, Mum. Thanks for coming to pick me up.
Oh, that's all right. I hope my daughter hasn't been too much trouble to you people.
Not at all.
Good luck, Quin.
Oh, gee, thanks, Mrs. Powell.
Don't come back.
Well, come along then, Faye. We'd better get home.
Colleen, can I see you for a minute?
Yeah.
Patrick's been here.
What?
Yes, this morning he came to see me.
You?
And I'm afraid Joan is making quite a meal out of the situation.
Why does he have to come here? God, I don't want everybody knowing my private affairs.
I'm sorry, Mick. He shouldn't try and involve you.
Well, he's desperate. I mean, he asked me for advice, but I prefer to keep well out of it.
Yes, well, better put a stop to it, hadn't I? I'll tell the gate guards they can refuse him entry next time he comes.
Don't you think that's going a bit too far?
Oh, what else can I do?
Must be nice to sit in comfy surroundings again, dear.
Yeah.
Well, now that you're home, we'd better see about getting you a job.
Oh, I'm in no hurry. I came out with a bit up my sleeve.
Oh, how much?
$73.
That won't last long, dear. You both can't manage on my pension.
I'll pay me way, Mum. Don't get your knickers in a knot.
Faye, such language. It shows the kind of company you've been keeping.
Yeah, there aren't too many nuns in Wentworth.
Oh, I wouldn't want your sister to hear you talking like that.
Hey, how are the kids? How's Billy?
Oh, he's growing up a treat. And Samantha's a lovely little girl, real little princess.
Oh, I really missed him. You know, I promised to take Billy Yabby in. If I don't hurry up, he'll be too grown up to care.
Oh, I don't think Glynis would approve of him yabbying, dear.
You reckon? Maybe I ought to pop over their place at the weekend. If she doesn't mind, we could go out Sunday.
Well, I think Billy's got scouts on Sunday. He won't be home.
He'll be home sometime in the evening.
Well, I think Glynda said something about him going to a camp or something of the sort.
Come off it, Mum. He's got to be home sometime.
Faye, I wouldn't go bothering your sister's family for a while yet, dear.
I see. Okay, then.
I don't reckon you should be watching it at all, Maggie. I do, Lizzie. Now cut it out and don't touch it. Oh, Lizzie, would you stop the noise, please?
Any more arguments about that and I'll have to turn it off.
No, we wouldn't want that, would we?
Oh, she's sweet, Mrs. Morrison. Can we watch it be?
No point voting to accept it if you're not going to watch it.
How'd you get on? Nola get in the net?
Depends how you look at it. She pleaded guilty to Patty's murder and the whole thing was a big farce.
So all they did was hear the evidence?
Yeah, right.
Where they put her, Bea?
She went back to her cell.
You mean she's still back in here?
Well, where else? The bitch got life, which means she got a stay of extradition and possible execution for the next 7 or 8 years.
God, that means that she's gotten away with Patty's murder.
Well, I wouldn't call rotten in here getting away with it exactly.
Damn sight better than hanging. I'll give her 10 out of 10 for planning. You should have seen her face when the indictment was being read. Looked like she enjoyed it. Almost tempted to commit perjury and the bitch sent back WA. I would have been thinking of Patty.
I suppose that's the end of it. There's nothing more that we can do.
Not quite, is it? She still has me to face. Judge, jury, and executioner.
Tell me you're going to be a guest here for quite some time.
That's right.
Well, I think that we should come to an arrangement.
Don't tell me you've got to pay for it these days.
Shut your mouth. You know what this is, and you know where it came from. Your front lady wasn't too eager to part with it, but I managed to persuade her for the good of her health.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I'm talking about a little corner store full of buy-up goodies. And all the other neat little transactions you've been involved in since you came here. I'm talking about a prison officer who just might turn a blind eye and who just might make it possible for you to replenish your stock at a price. 50% of the take.
You're talking double dutch.
All right, McKenzie. We'll play it your way for now. We've got plenty of time. But sooner or later, you'll find it much more profitable to accept my rules.
$10.
tell you, we gotta watch Barbara Stanwyck.
Well, I don't want to watch an old movie, Lizzie.
It's Barbara Stanwyck or nothing.
Well, I reckon it's the wild one or nothing.
Oh, cut it out. Okay, you lot, who wants to watch the Barbara Stanwyck movie? Only four. Who wants to watch the Barkey movie?
I can't, ladies.
Oh, guess what? It's a dead heat. Bad luck. That means I get to decide.
Oh, so I suppose now we can't watch it at all.
Of course you can watch it.
Oh, gee, thank you, B. But I get the casting vote, remember?
Oh, B.
Nobody watches current affairs.
I do.
God, you're a spoilsport. I'm going to go to the library.
Since when have you been able to read?
So, I'll look at some pictures or something. I only know I don't want to stay in here.
Nola, you got any cigarettes on offer for now?
Sorry, it can't be done. Well, the screws might get on me and I've got to lie low.
Oh, just one pack, baby. Look, I go crazy without a smoke.
Sorry, no.
What's wrong with you, wandering around with your naked face hanging out?
Nola's shut up shop. She thinks there might be some screws onto her.
Does she now? What with me and the screws? You have to have eyes in the back of her head.
Would you like one?
No, no, you go right ahead.
What's the trouble?
Tired, fed up.
Really threw you, Patrick, coming to Wentworth today, didn't it?
Yep, it did. God, he could make me so mad I could knife him.
I'll get it.
If it's him, I've gone abroad.
Hi, Meg.
Oh,
Meg.
Chris. Hi. Hello, come on in.
This is Miranda, and
Miranda?
This is Stephen.
Stephen?
Look, I hope you don't mind me bringing them along, but there's nobody at home to look after them.
No, that's fine.
There won't be any trouble.
Good. Hello, you two. Look, I'm not sure what we've got in our fridge, but there's bound to be some fruit juice. Would that do?
Oh, look, whatever's going. Thanks very much. No, Colleen. No.
Come on.
Okay. Well, I'd better get started then.
Right, well, you know where it is.
Yep. I'll just be out here, kids.
What are you looking for? Popular Mechanics.
Well, there's nothing much on telly I want to watch.
That's not what I heard.
Yeah? Well, maybe your ears need cleaning.
You looking for a job by any chance?
Like what?
Well, now Faye's gone, I still need cover. Someone to do the legwork.
And you want me for the runner? No way.
Why not? You could use a few extra bucks in your pocket, couldn't you?
Maybe.
Well, Faye did all right out of it. She got out of here on time with money to spend. Quite a role she had.
Yeah? How much?
Nearly $100, I heard, once she got her wages. Are you worried about what Smith might do? She let Faye get away with it, didn't she? And she backed off over the TV set. Smith's nothing in my books. You want protection from her? I'll give it to you.
Well, I could do with the extra dough.
Of course you could. You'll work for me. I'm not asking you, Daniels. I'm telling you.
Okay, here are your drinks.
Chris, coffee's up. Take a break.
Right there.
No, no. They're not being a pest, are they?
Oh. No, they're fine. Look, honestly.
They can come out the back with me, you know.
No, they're all right.
All right. I'll get back to it.
Aren't you going to take a break?
No, I'd better get as much done as I can, I reckon.
Well, he seems to be coping okay. They are good kids. That might have all right.
Well, at least Jennifer's older. Pressure on Patrick would be far less.
No, not less. Different.
Look, Colleen, you've got sensible kids. They'd understand probably more than you realise. And probably better able to cope than Patrick.
Wish I could believe that.
Anything promising?
I just skimmed through so far.
Well, it pays to really comb the situation's vacant.
Yeah,
but this is yesterday Arvo's paper. I mean, most of these would have gone already.
Where are you going?
I thought I'd better get the morning paper.
After you've had your brekkie, Faye.
Oh, Mum, I'm not hungry. Stop fussing. It's you wants me to get a job.
I didn't know you were back amongst us again.
Yeah, I got back yesterday.
I see you didn't waste any time coming back to the club.
Nah.
You could be losing your old touch, though.
Reckon it's a bit of a nag.
Wouldn't put my shirt on it.
Oh, I don't know. I got a fancy for it.
You must have. I've seen better legs on a table than that old bag of hay.
There you go, 50.
Okay, it's your money, Faye.
Yeah, and I'll be back to collect with interest.
Then.
Yeah, I'm still looking.
It's all very well to look, Faye, but if you really want to get a job, you'll have to ring some of these people up.
Yeah, I know, I was gonna.
Anything interesting?
Oh, yeah. They're advertising for an open heart surgeon at the Queen Vic. No experience necessary.
I'm glad all this nastiness hasn't made you lose your sense of humour. I'll go get a cuppa.
Go on, Lizzie. It's time to get some orders in. You help me and I'll...
When will you learn that I decide who does what around here?
Pecking order can be changed.
Oh, my dead body.
Don't tempt me. Or I'd break my arm, put me in hospital, Smith. See if I care. With you in solitary, I reckon I can sew up this place for the duration. You should get yourself insured.
All right, go on. Give Maxine the basket. What's got into you, Maxie?
Well, I'm only trying to make some money, Lizzie.
Don't you realise she's only using you to cover for herself? If the screws are onto her, you're the one who'll get stuffed and McKenzie will see to it.
They won't catch me. And if they do, well, I'm insured, aren't I? Don't worry, I won't get caught.
Yeah, it's only a matter of time when you do. Don't think you can come crawling back to me for protection!
What do you want?
Three.
Three. Right. Yeah, what about you?
Two. If so.
Yeah, thanks. Okay. Right, later on, okay?
Hey, what about you? I've got cigarettes, I've got chocolates, I'm getting some face cream and some powder.
Yeah, I need cigarettes, but I haven't got any money. I'm expecting a visit from Chris, though. He'll probably pass me a few dollars, yeah?
Rightio. You can pay me later, eh?
Put me down for a couple of packets of rollies.
Right, you got him.
Good.
See you later.
So I think that'll be the best procedure.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Powell. I've come to see my wife.
Sign in, please.
Oh, yeah. Are you feeling all right today? Looked a bit bushed by the time I left last night.
Mr. Young's a carpenter. He's doing some spare time work at Meg's unit. Extra cupboards, drawers, that sort of thing.
I see. Well, I think you might have let me know, Mrs. Powell. This is not personal, Mr. Young, but for obvious reasons, we don't encourage social relations between the officers and the families of inmates.
This is hardly social, Mrs. Davidson. Meg made the arrangement some time ago, before Janice Young was here. We only found out about the relationship last night, didn't we, Mr. Young?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right.
Well, it certainly is a remarkable coincidence.
Yeah, it's a small world, all right.
If you come with me, I'll take you to your wife.
Yeah, thanks.
Daniels.
What have I done?
Why hasn't Birdsworth taken the basket around? It's her job.
Yeah, well, Lizzie was feeling a bit tired, Miss Ferguson, so I took over for her.
Tired, eh? And the poor old thing wasn't up to pushing a heavy basket around.
Oh, fair. Go, how do you reckon you'll be when you're her age?
Any more remarks like that, Daniels, and you'll be around to find out. I thought so.
What are you going to do?
Just go, Daniels.
Hey? You mean you're not going to put me on report?
I said go.
What are you doing back here so fast?
Well, I was on my way around when Ferguson got onto me.
Oh, no. How much did she get?
Oh, geez, I don't know. A whole lot, maybe $10.
You silly little bitch.
Yeah, well, she got me list as well, so now I can't do a checkup.
The list? Now she'll know everyone who's dealing.
Not the way Maxine writes it, unless you can read hieroglyphics.
Your first time out and you bugger it up for me.
Ah, you never do anything by halves, do you, Maxine? You could have drawn any screw, but no, it had to be Ferguson.
Well, she didn't put me on report, B.
Of course she didn't. She wants a piece of the action.
She can try, but she won't get it, though. Nobody muscles in on me.
Pretty big words, McKenzie, but seeing you wriggle out of this one is going to prove more entertaining than your lousy television set.
I've met her type before. I know how to handle freaks like her.
Well, I hope you're right. Because around here there's one crime worse than lagging, and it's called sucking up to Ferguson. And if I ever find out you're dealing with the freak, I'll deal with you once and for all. And remember, McKenzie, that particular screw is so hated, I'll have all Wentworth on my side.
Shower away, lad. Dashed away now. Queen of the night trying hard in second place, but Shower Away Lad getting a bit tired near the line, but is holding on, and Shower Away Lad wins by a length. Queen of the night second, very tight for third, Collar Canyon or Range Lad.
Feel like a cuppa?
Oh, yes, please, Mum.
I must say, I'm so glad to see you looking so happy.
Well, things are going pretty good, aren't they? There's a lot of casual jobs in the paper. I'm sure I'll be able to get one tomorrow without too many hassles.
Oh, that is good news. No wonder you're looking so pleased. Faye, I never thought I'd say this, but being in prison seems to have made a new person of you. I'll go get the tea.
The official placings, number 3, Shower Away Lad, 1st, 4, Queen of the Night, 2nd.
So there's no trading in progress?
Beats me.
You have a choice, McKenzie. I'm feeling particularly generous today. Now, either you let me in on your little enterprise, or I take this list and this money and you, and we all pay a little social call on the governor.
Oh, come off it. You've got nothing on me and you know it.
I don't think I'd have any trouble getting a few facts out of Daniels. She doesn't have a very big vocabulary, but it's big enough to lag on you.
Nobody lags around here. You ought to know that.
Listen, if I stage a search, how long do you think it'd take to tear this wing apart and expose your little treasure trove? And then you'd be finished. Instead of which it could be the beginning.
You finish me, and I promise you I'll take a few people with me. Screws included.
You don't impress me, McKenzie. I've dealt with the likes of you for years. So, it's over. Either we're partners, or you've just made yourself the worst enemy you'll ever have.
Give me roses, I wish he could again,
but that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around,